I've done it. I have finally done it. The 2-year agreement that I had with this phone is finally over, which really can only mean one thing. Upgrade time, baby.
Oh.
But before you go chirping your tires to pick up the latest and greatest, something you need to consider. Will upgrading your current device actually make your life simpler? So to help you answer that question, I'm gonna share with you a very well and very time-consuming list that I have compiled of the latest and greatest cell phones from Android and Apple, and there's a third. And we're gonna consolidate that list by identifying which phones are compatible with what I believe to be the 3 most important categories when it comes to diabetes tech. And then we'll wrap it all up and I will provide you with 5 cell phones that you need to look for that will seamlessly integrate with your diabetes tech for 2023 and 2024. Let's get into it. All right, the first and most popular category is the CGM. And when it comes to a continuous glucose monitor, there are really 2 major players in the market today, which is Dexcom and Libre. But here's the thing. Did you know that there are currently a whopping 138 Android and iPhone models that are compatible with just
the Dexcom G6?
And out of those, 110 are Android. And those are various companies like Samsung, LG, Sony, Google, and Motorola. Now, if you're eyeing the next-gen Dexcom G7, the list gets a little bit shorter, but still pretty impressive with an additional 100 and... Someone's calling me. No scam likely. And that adds another 106 compatible devices, including Samsung, Google, and iPhone models. So that brings our total to carry the one, parentheses first, something about my Aunt Sally, coefficients. That brings our total to 244 options. And that's just G6 and G7. When we add Libre 2 and 3, well, that's another 176 additional phones, bringing our grand total to 420 different cell phone options. It's just crazy. So here's the million-dollar question. If you had to pick out a new phone today, like I want to, that would work with your CGM, would you opt in for one that is compatible with your current continuous glucose device or the next gen one? I mean, in theory, technology literally outdates itself and doubles every 2 years. Every. Is there that many syllables in every? I don't think there is. Every 2 years, which means this clunky old thing that you got 2 years ago should be out of date, or is it? So a couple things to consider here. If we're smart, we're definitely not gonna get an outdated phone, but also what you gotta consider is the newest phone probably isn't even on the compatibility list yet. So, ugh. Category 2, insulin pumps. Now, if you're on the hunt for the perfect smartphone, there's something crucial you gotta factor in, and that is the possibility of transitioning to an insulin pump. Now, Medtronic has long been the reigning champion in the realm of insulin pumps, but this last year, we witnessed huge leaps and bounds by Insulin when they took their Omnipod Dash to the Omnipod 5. Now, Tandem's T-Slim X2 and the Omnipod 5 really led the charge in introducing most of the world to a fully FDA-approved version of a hybrid closed loop. And in case you're wondering what this jargon means, according to JDRF, a hybrid closed loop system takes readings from your continuous glucose monitor, your CGM, and it employs a clever algorithm to instruct an insulin pump on precisely how much insulin to administer. And this happens 24/7. Automatically. So if your blood sugar starts to climb, the CGM communicates with the pump and voila, insulin is automatically delivered. And if your sugar takes a nosedive, again, the CGM chats with the pump, which wisely suspends insulin to keep you from going low. And if you're about to chow down and need a few units, never fear, you could simply grab your phone and request a bolus. It's pretty darn brilliant. And if you're really still unfamiliar with this tech, don't worry, I have some videos. Check those out. They're pretty good. Now, here's the cool part. If you happen to have the right phone, like the S21, all of these interactions can happen with just a single device. So what I'm saying is if you have the right device, you don't have to lug around a receiver, a transmitter, and a cell phone just to sync up all of your diabetes tech devices. The S21, for me, covers all of those things, and this is the only thing in my pocket currently to manage my diabetes tech. But say you're like me and you're in the market for a new phone for no other reason other than they're shiny and iPhone 15 just came out and it looks amazing, but you know it's expensive and you know it probably won't work with your cell phone. What do we do? You gotta also consider whether or not your pump is gonna work with it. And what do those lists look like? Well, I looked at them and there's a lot of things on there. The Omnipod 5 currently supports around 45 different devices, primarily Samsung, with a couple of Google phones. Yet, no iPhone yet. Yeah, nothing. Nada. Zip, zilch. So what's another word for, I don't know that many languages. Now the T-Slim X2, on the other hand, from Tandem, plays nice with 34 devices, but 18 of those are iPhone, and then 16, on the other hand, are Samsung, so that's nice. Now, by merging these two lists together, we can now embark on the process of elimination by identifying similar devices and then clearing away those that are not really as compatible. But not before we talk about wearables, because those are important too. Hey, if you're a type 1, type 2, MADI, or LADA, and content like this, specific for diabetics, is important to you, make sure you subscribe to this channel, and I will do my best to keep you up to date on what's going on in the world of diabetes. Category 3, smartwatches. Now, before we wrap up our list, it's crucial to factor in the world of wearables. And as you know, both Apple and Android offer a range of smartwatches that can track a plethora of metrics. Plethora, you like that? That's an old reference. If you know what that's from, let me know in the comments. These metrics track things like mental and physical health. Android, powered by Wear OS, is compatible with various smart brands such as Samsung, TicWatch, Pixel, Fossil, and even the prestigious Tagear. Tagear, however you say it. With these watches, you have the capability to monitor your glucose readings from your CGM using a third-party app that seamlessly shares data from the cloud, such as Dexcom Share. Now, Apple users aren't left behind either. They can also utilize these types of third-party apps. However, there is an upgrade on the horizon that deserves our attention. So pay attention. According to Dexcom CEO Kevin Sayre, in the not-so-distant future, possibly by December, Apple Watch will be able to directly receive your CGM numbers via Bluetooth. What does that mean? Well, this development is exceptionally significant for individuals who want the freedom to leave their phones behind, but still wish to keep tabs on their diabetes right from their wrists, because this will talk to this without this. Okay, it is the moment we have all been waiting for, and here's the big reveal. Now, just a quick heads up, these compatibility lists, they're always changing. So don't hesitate to check the description for links to any updates that may happen between now and the time you watch this video. So to determine the results, I have established a set of criteria based on devices that consistently showed up as compatible with Dexcom G6, 7, Libre 2, 3, Omnipod 5, Tandem X2, and Wear OS 4, or Watch OS if you're an Apple person. And after digging through a mountain of device options, two major players kept popping up without fail. That is Samsung.
Hi.
And Apple.
Hello there.
But I found a third contender. Taking the top spot, the Samsung S22. Now, several versions of this phone proved to be compatible with all 7 diabetes tech devices. That's right, it plays nice with Dexcom G6, 7, Libre 2, 3, Omnipod 5, Tandem T-Slim X2, and even syncs seamlessly with Wear OS 4 smartwatches. Nice. I don't know why that. Okay, next one, Samsung S21. Oh, hello there. This old thing. Yes, this trusty companion is the phone I currently use, and surprisingly, the S21 was found also on all 7 compatibility lists as well. It's a reliable pickup for the Dexcom G6 and 7. It works with Libre 2 and 3, Omnipod 5, Tandem X2, and also Wear OS 4 watches. But what about the iPhones, you might ask, or you might not ask. I'm asking, what about the iPhones? Next up, iPhone 13. Yes, it could have easily taken the top spot, but there's a small hiccup. It has an insulet problem, not an insulin. I have an insulin problem. It has an insulet. Insulet. I'll explain. According to Omnipod on their website, the Omnipod 5 app for iPhone is still pending 510K clearance and is not yet available for sale within the United States. So now when this changes, you could go ahead and put the iPhone 13 up to the top, but you can't yet because the iPhone 13 is compatible with only 6 out of the 7 major categories, including Dexcom G6 and 7, Libre 2 and 3, Tandem T-Slim X2, and Watch OS. So, a good option, just not perfect yet. Or maybe it is by the time you watch this video, I hope. I don't know why I'm pointing at you, it's very rude. Here, look, every time I point at you, these guys are pointing at me, huh? Worse on me because I got 3 guys. 3. Next, the iPhone 12. And like its predecessor, it's a fantastic phone, but it faces the same Omnipod compatibility hiccup. Nevertheless, it makes the list for being compatible with 6 out of the 7 major categories covering Dexcom G6 and 7, Libre 2 and 3, Tandem T-Slim X2, and Watch OS. But wait, there's one left. And it's not a Samsung. And it's not an iPhone. Can you guess what it is? I'm pointing. I am sorry. I'm rude. Lastly, for all you non-Apple and non-Samsung enthusiasts, the Google Pixel 6. Just like the iPhone, the Pixel also provides compatibility with 6 of the 7 devices. The only difference here is it's not supported by Tandem. So no T-Slim X2. The Pixel does, however, sync seamlessly with the Dexcom G6 and 7, Libre 2 and 3, Omnipod 5, and Wear OS 4 watches. So there you have the breakdown, the top smartphone contenders that'll keep your diabetes tech running smoothly. Make your choice wisely and you'll be good for the foreseeable future until I remake this list, probably 6 months from now. Either way, I'm Ben, I'm Type Me, and I will see you next time.